Hi, my name is Raymond Gosson, and I will present text execution. So, what is text execution? Text execution is based on the read, select, subnet, test, suite to the executable for the cycle. Assign the test cases in each test suite to tester for execution. Execute test, report bugs, and capture test status continuously. Resolve blocking issue as they arise. Report status, adjust assignment, and reconsider plan and priority dailies. Report test cycle finding status. So, ang test execution is, ito yung parang pinaka final test na. Yung ginagawa nila is, parang tinetest na nila para at kinukumpara sa realidad para malaman nila yung parang pinakalalabas sa system na kanilang ginagawa. Kadalasan dito malalaman yung mga major bugs sa ibang report na kailangan pang baguhin upang mas mapaganda ang isang system na ginagawa. Dito rin nila ginagawa ng plano upang maisaayos yung project na system na kanilang ginagawa. There are some activities for test execution. The object of this phase is real-time validation of AUT because moving on the production release. To sign off from this phase, the QA team perform different types of testing, ensure the quality of product, along with the defect reporting, and retesting is also crucial activity in this phase. Following important activities of this phase. First is system integration testing. System integration testing, or SIT, is a black box testing technique that evaluates the system compliance against specified requirement or test cases prepared. System integration testing is usually performed on subset of system. The SIT can be performed with minimum usage testing tools, verified for the interaction exchange and the behavior of each data field within individual layer is also investigated. After the integration, there are three main state of data flow. Data state within the integration layer, 2. Data state within the database layer, and 3. Data state within the application layer. So, defect reporting. Defect reporting is a process of finding defect in the application under test or product by testing or recording feedback from the customer and make new version of the product that fix the defect based on the client feedback. So, ibig sabihin na ito, dinedetect nila yung mga defect na pwede mangyari sa isang system at humingi sila ng isang feedback or mga feedback na pwedeng isuggest ng kanilang customer or ng client nila. So, pagkakataong to, kaya nila ginagawa to para mas malaman nila yung mga pwedeng mangyaring bug sa isang system at maayos nila ito. The purpose of this defect report is to state the problem as clearly as possible, so the developers can replicate in the defect easily and fix it. Defect tracking is also an important process in software engineer as a complex and business critical system have hundreds of defects. One of the most challenging factors is managing, evaluating, and patronizing this effect. The number of defects gets multiplied over a period of time, and to effectively manage them, defect tracking system is used to make the job easier. So, ibig sabihin nun, yung defect, mabilis kumalat. At kayang-kayang sumira agad ng isang codings mo kung hindi mo to maaagapan. Next is defect mapping. Once defect is reported and logged, it will be mapped with the concerned failed block, test cases, and corresponding requirements in requirement. Traceability matrix. This mapping is done by the defect reporter It helps to make a proper defect report and analyze the effectiveness in the product. Once the test cases and requirements are mapped with the defect, stakeholders can analyze and take decision whatever to fix the defect based on the priority severity. So, itong defect mapping is yung parang paglilista ng mga nakuwang defect. Then, sila yung mag-a-analyze kung paano ba ayusin yung nangyaring defect na to, kung anong ipapalit nila para mas maging maayos ang isang system na kanilang ginagawa. So, next is retesting. Retesting and executing a previously failed test against AUT to check whether the problem is resolved after the defect has been fixed. Retesting is performed to check the scenario under the same environmental condition. So, ibig sabihin nito, pagtas ng defect reporting, then defect mapping, mag-retesting sila sa ganong scenario pa rin. Para malaman nila kung uulit ba uli ang naging defect na to o kaya yung bugs na ito. Na pwede uli mangyari sa isang system na kanilang ginawa. During the retesting, tester look the granular details at the change area of functionality. Where areas regression testing cover all the main function to ensure that no functionalities are broken due to this change. So, ibig sabihin ito, kaya sila nagre-retesting para malaman nila kung may nasira ba sa kanilang ginawa nung nagkaroon ng defect. Kung may nagbago ba, kasi babaguhin nila yung coding. So, baka may magbago. Dahil once na baguhin mo ang isang code sa isang system at ito ay mali, lahat ito magiging mali o maapektuhan ng ibang code dahil magkakagulo-gulo ito. So, yung final testing is regression testing. Once all defects are enclosed, deferred or rejected status and none of the test cases are in progress, failed, no run status, it can be said that system integration testing is completely based on the test cases and requirement. However, one round of the quick testing is required to ensure that one of the functionality is broken through the code changes or defect fixes. Ang ibig sabihin ng regression testing is finding the old bug fixes if it came back after fix it. So, ibig sabihin na ito, kaya nirarun uli yung isang testing or regression testing is kung hahanapin kung ang nice na bug ay bumabalik uli at muli makakasira ng isang system. Para malaman din to kung ang inayos mo na code o bug ay tama ba o hindi. Ang regression testing is yung pinakalas part ng testing execution. Para malaman kung lahat ng defect o bugs na nangyari sa system mo ay kung babalik pa ba o hindi na. At malaman mo kung may impact ba o may naging damage ba yung mga defect na nangyari sa system mo. Merong dalawang types of regression test. First is final regression test. A final regression testing is performed to validate the build that has not undergone a change for a period of time. This build is deployed or shipped to the customer. So, ibig sabihin lang ng final regression test is yung parang last test na. Titingnan nila kung yung bug na yun ay uulit pa kapag tumagal na yung system. At muli nila itong itetest bago i-release ang isang system. Next is regression test. A normal regression testing is performed to verify if the build does not broken and other parts of the application by the recent code change for the defect. Fixing for enhancement. So, ito, regular lang to na ginagawa para malaman kung may mga nagbabago ba, ito yung normal lang na testing na bine-verify lang nila kung yung system mo o may parte ng yung application mo is sira or hindi pa nagana. Or merong ibang parte ng code mo is nag-error. Ito ay para malaman lamang at maayos agad ng maayos. At yun lang po ang aking report. Maraming salamat.